Here we want to apply the sum and difference identity and then simplify. So we have the sine of the quantity x plus pi over 2. So using our identity, we know that a is equal to x and b is equal to pi over 2. And since we have a sum of these two angles, this is the top operation here. We'll use the top operation here, which is plus. So wherever we see angle A, we'll replace it with x. So we'll have sine x here and cosine x here. And we'll substitute pi over 2 for b. So I'll cosine pi over 2 here and sine pi over 2 here. So we'll have the sine of x times cosine pi over 2 plus cosine x times the sine of pi over 2. And now we can evaluate cosine pi over 2 and sine pi over 2. Well, cosine pi over 2 is equal to 0, and sine pi over 2 is equal to 1. So this is 0, and this is going to be cosine x. Sine of the quantity x plus pi over 2 is equal to cosine x. Let's go ahead and try a second example. Here we have the same type of problem, but now we're going to have to apply both the difference identity for sine and sum identity for cosine. So in both cases, notice that A is the first angle. So we'll have pi over 6 here, here, and here. And we'll have pi over 3 here and here. And then the second angle here is B in both cases. So for the difference identity for sine, this is y, so we'll have a y here and a y here. And then for the sum identity for a cosine, b is equal to y, so we'll have y here and y here. And since we have a minus sign here, notice it's the bottom operation, we'll have a minus sign here. And then for cosine, since we have an addition sign here, which is the top operation, we'll have a minus sign here. So let's go ahead and write all this out. We're going to have the sine of pi over 6 times the cosine of y minus cosine pi over 6 times the sine of y plus, now we'll apply the cosine identity. So we'll have cosine pi over 3 times cosine y. And since we're using the plus sign here, we'll use the minus sign. And then we'll have sine pi over 3 times sine of y. Notice here we have pi over 6 and pi over 3. So let's go ahead and sketch a 30, 60, 90 reference triangle. And now we'll evaluate sine pi over 6, cosine pi over 6, cosine pi over 3, and sine pi over 3. So the sine of pi over 6 or 30 degrees will be 1/2. Cosine of pi over 6 is going to be square root 3 over 2. Cosine pi over 3 is going to be 1/2. And the sine of pi over 3 is going to be equal to square root 3 over 2. And now we just need to combine like terms. Notice here we have 1/2 cosine y plus 1/2 cosine y. That simplifies nicely to cosine y. Then here we have negative square root 3 over 2 sine y minus negative square root 3 over 2 sine y. So you can think of this as negative 1/2 square root 3 over 2 and another negative 1/2 square root 3 over 2. So that's going to be negative 2 square root of 3 over 2, or just negative square root 3 times sine y. And now we've applied the identities and simplified.